right, Jake, call him at 12.
Okay, girls, 12 o'clock tomorrow.
Come on, Julie, let's hear the new song.
I don't feel like singing.
Oh, don't you? What do you feel like doing, Duchess?
I feel like going off on a tear.
Come on, Julie, let Mr. Green hear the song.
Come on, Julie.
It's a good one, Mr. Green.
I used to dream that I would discover the perfect lover someday. I knew I'd recognize him if ever he came round my way. And I always used to fancy then he'd be one of the godlike kind of men, with a giant brain and a noble head, like the heroes bold in the books I've read. But along came Bill, who's not the type at all. You meet him on the street and never notice him. His form and face, his manly grace, are not the kind that you would find in a statue. Oh, I can't explain. It's surely not his brain that makes me thrill. I love him because he's wonderful, because he's just my Bill. He can't play golf or tennis or polo or sing a solo or row. He isn't half as handsome as dozens of men that I know. He isn't tall or straight or slim, and he dresses far worse than Ted or Jim. I can't explain why he should be just the one man in the world for me. He's just my Bill, an ordinary man. He hasn't got a thing that I can brag about, and yet to be upon his knee, so comfy and roomy, seems natural to me. Oh, I can't explain. It's surely not his brain that makes me thrill. I love him because he's, I don't know, because he's just my Bill.
Use it tomorrow night. And listen, be sober.
I'll be sober. If you want me, I'll be in my dressing room.